party people, I see you out there. I see you with your hands in the sky. Real quick, I'ma tell you who this video is sponsored by. Ready? When I say square, you say space. Square. Square. When I say square, you say space. Square.
Happy birthday.
Let's get it cracking.
Hey, what's up, y'all? I'm 1000. I'm an artist from Southwest Michigan.
Woo!
I met a tasty baby in Michigan. Welcome to the channel. Thanks for hanging out. Thanks for kicking it. Well, I was cruising around on the old internet, and I was thinking to myself,
I don't have an idea for a video.
What should I do? So I found this site called Quick Character Generator. Now, I've done a video before where we did a random creature generator. It was crazy. We did like the Ooflahi, and it had like 18 legs and praying mantis claws and an orangutan face and just making super bizarre creatures. But I think with this Quick Character Generator that I have here, it's gonna make more human characters. It might give us a little detail about those characters, and I think it'll be a fun art challenge. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna generate some random characters, and then I'm gonna try and draw them. Whatever this website tells me, that's the piece of art that I have to make. This should be fun. This should be interesting, but let's just jump in and see what kind of crazy characters they're gonna give us. All right, I'm a little bit nervous. I am going to click this generate button. Boom. Generated. Here we go. Okay, name. This character's name is Aiden Patel. He's 19. His appearance. Standing short and slender with olive skin, Aiden has a goofy feel about them. They have a round face, a big nose, thin lips. Dude, why are they describing me? This is not fair. And their blue eyes are large. Okay, I don't have blue eyes, so whew. Okay, they're not describing me. They usually wear perfectly pressed, fabulous clothes that are mostly colorful and well-fitting. Yes, Aiden, my dude. And they wear no jewelry. They are usually seen wearing a specific turban. Ooh, exciting. Okay, these are all gonna be pretty fun to draw. Personality, approachable, courteous, happy, inventive, funny, boastful. Man, me and Aiden would really, I think we'd be friends. I think we'd get along. Social class, upper class, we got a rich boy. Marital status, betrothed. Homosexual. Their job is a carpenter. They're 89% satisfied with their job.
Excuse me, Aiden. On a scale from 1 to 100, how satisfied would you say you are with your job?
89.
Okay, good to know.
Financial status. Rich. It's funny that he's upper class and he's rich and he's a carpenter. He must be a really good carpenter because I don't know a ton of people getting like super upper class rich off the carpenter game. But, you know, maybe that's just my preconceived notions and I really just need to open my mind up. Religious view, atheist. Worldview, realist. Racial views, I think some... I'm not going to say that out loud. I'm not trying to get demonetized. Gender bias, judge people based on their ability, not gender. Nationalism, my country isn't the best or the worst. I mean, you know, he is a realist and that is what it is about his country. Conflict, violence solves everything. He's usually approachable, courteous, happy, and yet he says violence solves everything. Oh, man. He gets all that rage out in his carpentry. He's just like pounding random chunks of wood like, oh, violence solves everything. Physical health, frequently sniffles. What's up, I'm Aiden. Aiden, what you been doing in your pastime? Dislike stomach cramps. He dislikes stomach cramps. What a strange thing to dislike. Normally, everyone loves stomach cramps. They're like the best thing ever. He dislikes people who are always late, same, and slow cashiers. His motivator is immaturity. I don't even know what that means. Jeez, you know what really just wakes me up in the morning and says, hey, I'm gonna start my day of carpentry? Immaturity. Music, likes jungle. Foods, sweet food, book genre, classic. Aiden sounds like quite the complex character. He's like, you know, kind of a yin and yang kind of dude. He's got some things that really just contradict other things about his personality. But when we search deep inside, isn't that true for all of us? Anyway, I'm gonna bust out my paper, my pencil, and we are going to draw Aiden Patel. This is gonna be interesting. Here we go. Okay, let's draw Aiden. So they said he has a round face. So let's just rough in a little face here. Now it said he had like large blue eyes. So let's just rough some eyes in here. I kind of feel like a police sketch artist doing this. We're gonna give him some larger eyes. Throw some brows in there. And then they said Aiden had a big nose and thin lips. So let's
See if I can give him a big old nose. This is super fun, just like drawing a character based off of like a written description. I really do feel like a police sketch artist. And some thin lips. I know what it's like to struggle with them thin lips. Let's give him a little smile, because he, you know, they said he was like kind of a happy dude who thinks violence solves everything. Little erase in action. Erase like this. Tap, tap. All right, my dude. They said he wears what did they say? A specific turban. They didn't say specifically what it was, but let's go ahead and give him a turban. I don't think I've ever really drawn a turban before, but no time like the present. Let's just kind of go for it. Just kind of winging it. Does that kind of look like a turban? I guess so. Throw some like folds in the fabric. It's kind of got some turban vibes. Am I right? This side looks a little lopsided. No one wants a lopsided turban. Aiden Patel is starting to take shape here. This reminds me of like that game Guess Who, where they just, you're like, does your guy wear glasses? Does your guy wear a turban? Does he have thin lips and a large nose? I loved that game. Felt like a detective every time I played it. It's got little baby ears. Little baby ears. All right, now I don't know why, but I'm seeing Aiden with some kind of low sunglasses, some circular ones. You know, they said he is a fabulous dresser, but he doesn't wear jewelry. But I think he needs to accessorize a little bit. So we'll give him some sunglasses that he just rocks real low. Let's give him a little facial hair just to add a bit of intrigue or something. Some just more details to Aiden. A little bit of facial hair, wispy facial hair. Creeper goatee going on. Creepy goatee. That's the facial hair for me. Now it says he's short and slender with perfectly pressed, fabulous clothes. So even though he's got kind of a round head, we'll give him more of a slender build. This guy is like a straight up bobblehead. Oh, he's awesome so far. He looks like a little baby man. Face of a baby, body of a skinny guy. Also, they said he wears a very specific turban, so I think we'll give him some kind of printed pattern on his turban, because right now it's not looking specific at all. So let's just kind of throw some kind of patterns here, make them all wobbly wobbly as though they're going over folds. Yeah, that pattern's looking pretty tight. Let's keep that going. Oh, hex yeah, Aiden, now you styling on him, bro. Looking good. Got that specific turban. All right, now for some clothes. Just kind of making it up as I go along here. It's got to look fabulous. I don't know, just throwing in kind of a high collar here. Not sure exactly where this is going. Maybe we should give him some like some crazy like shoulder blades. I don't know what those are called, but superheroes have them on their costumes, so seems pretty fabulous to me, you know. Shoulder blades. Sick. Dude, what was with shoulder pads? What kind of crazy fashion moment was that when all the ladies were rocking those big old chunky shoulder pads? You looking flossy, Aiden. This is the outfit that he puts on to go do carpentry. He's like, I may work hard, but I gotta look good while I do it. Maybe some like flowy sleeves. I freaking love this guy now. Now that he's got his like super swanky clothes on. Aiden, my dude. We'll make these stripey just for a bit more pizzazz. All right, now lastly, I think he should maybe be holding a hammer here just because, you know, he's a carpenter and also his beliefs on violence solving everything. Maybe he should be holding some form of a hammer. So we'll just rough a hand in here and we'll have his pinky kind of shooting out because, you know, he's upper class. He's a rich guy. So you got to get that pinky out. Maybe he's like the royal carpenter for the king, and that's why he's kind of balling. Okay, we got this kind of hammer, Thor-like hammer. And that is basically Aiden Patel. Now I'm just going to grab my Faber-Castell India ink markers and just start inking this thing. Okay, next one. Let's go ahead and generate. Boom. Name, Gina Robbins, age 13. Standing 5'2" tall and heavy with red-brown skin, Gina has a mad feel about them. They have a lean face with a round chin, a large nose, and puffy lips. Sweet. Their brown eyes are puffy and they have no eyebrows. Gina, looking good, girl. Their black hair is mid-back length and fine and is curly permed. Okay, Gina.
They usually wear masculine clothes that are mostly light colored, and they wear a silver amulet.
Cool.
Social class, aristocracy. Racial views, I would happily marry any race. Gender bias, women are not as smart as... Oh, Gina, you were doing so well. Why you gotta be like that, Gina? Nationalism, their country's equivalent of, yeah, America! They really wrote that. Wow. Conflict. When talking doesn't work, sometimes we're forced to fight. That's a little bit more reasonable than our boy Aiden. Physical health. Schizophrenic. Okay, things are starting to kind of come together. Quirks. Flirts all the time. Likes loitering and traveling. Those are literally opposite things. Dislikes. The concept of death. Wow, it's getting heavy. And badly fitted clothes. What's worse, the concept of death or badly fitted clothes? Afraid of being nude. Skills. Very good at creating art.
Yeah!
And very good at boxing. Oh, I wish I was very good at boxing. Likes funk, hates Bhangra. Dude, I don't know if I know what Bhangra is. Bhangra music. Oh, I think it's Indian music. Okay, learned something new today. Gina Robbins, you are a wild 13-year-old. You got a whole lot going on. I guess let's just jump in and see if we can draw Gina. Okay, Gina Robbins. So she has a lean face with a round chin. So I'm just gonna start by drawing me a circle here. We'll make kind of a round chin and a lean face. Got kind of a head shape going here for Gina. It says they have puffy eyes and no eyebrows, so I don't know exactly how to draw puffy eyes, but let's give it a whirl. Eyeball number one, eyeball number two. Now, how do we make these eyes puffy? Maybe just like that? Just wrinkles, hella wrinkles. Gina and her puffy eyes. Gina, you looking good already, girl. Don't let anybody tell you that your puffy eyes aren't beautiful. Cause you are beautiful, even with your puffy eyes. Puffy-eyed Gina. Sweet. Love her. And she's got no eyebrows. Now, it says she has a large nose and puffy lips as well. Gina got her large nose going here, looking good. But she's still got that lean face, so let's kind of give her some gaunt cheekbones. Gina, you are just looking better and better with every pencil stroke. And now those puffy lips. Oh yeah, Gina, you're looking good. Those lips just set it off. Got the puffy eyes, the big nose, the puffy lips, the lean face. Now, it says she has like curly permed hair, which is gonna take me a little bit of time to draw, but let's just jump into it. Oh, Gina, the curls will be the death of me. Now, in the description, they said Gina's supposed to be 13 years old, and let me tell you right now, she is not looking 13. All right, kind of got the hair going there. We'll detail that out a bit more once we're inking it. Now, it said she's a little bit heavy, so, and she wears masculine clothes, so we'll just kind of rough in a body here, and then we'll figure out her clothes. But Gina's looking good. All right, now what are we gonna do about her clothes? All right, well, it said her biggest fear is that she is afraid of being nude, so maybe she'll just be wearing like lots of shirts. And they said she has kind of a crazy, insane look about her, so maybe she put a little like fake bird in her hair just for a fashion accessory. It's just kind of clipped in there. Maybe she's got a little band-aid on her face because she's just always doing some wild stuff. Got into a bit of a scuffle. Oh, and then she wears this like silver amulet. I can't forget that. We're gonna put this kind of flying off to the side, and then we'll have these strings kind of just flying out here. But I think we're checking off all the check boxes. We got the puffy lips, the big nose, the puffy eyes, no eyebrows, the curly permed mid-back length hair. Got her amulet. She's afraid of being nude, so she has lots of layers of clothes on. They said she's got a mad look about her and that she was schizophrenic. I think we're getting close to being done with the pencils here. Is there any other details I forgot on Gina? She does dislike poorly fitted clothes. I don't know if these are like the best fit for her, but hopefully she doesn't dislike this. We don't want to piss Gina off any more than she already is, because she is a, maybe that's why she's got this intense look on her face. We're forcing her to wear some poorly fitted clothes. Well, there is my pencil sketch of Gina. I'm gonna jump in and do the inks, and yeah, Gina Robbins, there you go. Let's knock out these inks. Well, I'm actually gonna do one more because I'm having like a surprising amount of fun doing these crazy characters. But first, I gotta let you know that this video is brought to you by Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one dynamic platform to build a beautiful website, run your business, launch your brand, and share your creative vision with the world. I've used Squarespace personally for years and years and years. It's how I built my website. It's how I sell my online product and also host my artist gallery. With Squarespace's award-winning templates, it's never been easier to build a website. You don't need to be like a super professional coder or a website builder. You just take your amazing content, pop it into their beautiful, elegant templates, and you are off and running. But if you do run into any issues, they also have award-winning 24/7 customer support, and they've helped me out of a few issues in the past. So what are you waiting for? It's time for you to build a beautiful website. Whether you're an artist, filmmaker, photographer, woodworker, seamstress, whatever you are, you can have an amazing website with Squarespace. So when you're ready to sign up, go to squarespace.com. And when you're ready to launch your site, go to squarespace.com/1000 for 10% off your first purchase. Let's go, baby. Thank you, Squarespace, for sponsoring this vid. All right, let's get back into this random character generator. I'm having way too much fun with this dumb video. All right, last one. Boom, generate. Walter Gilmore, age 13, standing tall and very thin with pink skin. Ooh, Walter has an angry feel about him.
Walter, I'm tall, I'm thin, I'm angry. Get over it.
He has a narrow face, a narrow nose, angled lips, and his brown eyes are little.
Yeah.
This guy's gonna be fun to draw. His dark blonde hair is very short and fine and is styled with a crew cut. He usually wears immaculate matching clothes that are mostly neutral colored, and he wears no jewelry. Walter is a very angular fellow. Social class, middle class. He's an atheist. He's an idealist. Racial views. I'm only racist because of what I've been told. Maybe you should hang out with some different people, Walter. Gender bias. Women are not... Man, all these characters are just a little bit kind of close-minded. Age preference. Age equals wisdom. Nationalism. I'm not very patriotic. Conflict. I always try to avoid physical confrontations. Sounds like me. I think my last fight was in like third grade. Dislikes. Society.
Man.
He's so angsty.
Down with society.
And people who don't bring gifts for the host. Afraid of bees and hospitals. His motivator is rejection. If you reject him, he's going to show you. I mean, I can feel that. Every time somebody tells me I can't do something, I'm like,
oh yeah?
For music, he likes classical and he hates drum and bass. He likes sour food, and his favorite book genre is Pulp Fiction. Walter Gilmore. That's such like an old-timey name.
Walter Gilmore.
But he's only 13.
Walter Gilmore.
All right, Walter, let's bring you to life. All right, so Walter has a thin face. So I'm just gonna start with a rectangle here and we'll work from there. So it says he has a narrow face, narrow nose, angled lips, and small eyes. Everything about this guy is just narrow. And with some of those views we found out about him, he's kind of narrow-minded too. Let's give him his narrow nose. Got a nice little narrow nose going there for Walter.
Walter.
And they said he has an angled mouth. So I'll give him this kind of angled kind of mouth going here. They said he has a mean look about him. So we'll make him frowning. Now they said he has small eyes, so we'll give him these kind of small little beady eyes. And I'm seeing Walter is kind of shifty, so we'll have him kind of looking off to the side. Shifty Walter. And we'll give him kind of some angry eyebrows because he has this sort of mean look about him, these angled down eyebrows. Now they said that he has like a short kind of crew cut. He looks like a bully.
I'm Walter and I don't like it. I'm going to tell my father on you.
Come on, Walter. Why you gotta be like that? Man, Walter's looking like a real jerk, I'll tell you what. And then they said he was just slim and tall. So let's give him a long, exaggeratedly long neck. I'm gonna give him some, like, sunglasses resting on his head because I just feel like there's not a whole lot going on with Walter. And you know I love to accessorize my characters. Maybe he always has sunglasses ready to hide his small little beady eyes. And they said he wears, like, nice clothes. We'll give him kind of the, maybe a preppy kind of look. I don't know. Collared shirt. I just see him as, like, the school bully. Come on, Walter. Why you gotta be so angry all the time, bro?
Ugh, I never got the love I needed, so I'll take it out on you.
Walter. Walter, if you met Gina, I think Gina would win in a fight.
Oh yeah? I'll show her.
Okay, Walter. You talk a big game now. Maybe he's like one of those dudes that just like always has on the Bluetooth.
thinks he's really cool because he's like always talking on his Bluetooth. Just make him nice and lanky. Maybe he's got like a man bag. It's like the strap of his satchel. There's not a whole lot going on with Walter, but I think we're doing everything that was in the description. Definitely not the kind of character I would normally draw. He's a little vanilla for my liking. Maybe we'll give his shirt some stripes just for a little bit of something going on. I said he likes white. He likes neutral colors. Walter, I hate to say it, but you're kind of boring, bro.
Oh, yeah? I'll show you who's boring. Your mom's boring.
Come on, Walter. You can do better than that.
Shut up, punk.
Well, there's our long, skinny, angry, lanky, narrow-faced homie, Walter. I think that's as far as I can take him based on the description. But let's just jump in on the inks and make this pencil sketch a little more permanent. Well, that was fun. I made Aiden Patel, Gina Robbins, and Walter Gilmore.
Me, I'm Walter.
I can see these crazy characters having like a wild adventure together. They have really crazy different personalities. They'd probably get on each other's nerves. They'd probably get into a bunch of trouble, but maybe they'd come back home and have a new worldview. Maybe they'd learn some lessons. And that's what it's all about in the end. Let me know down in the comments which one of these characters was your favorite. I'll leave a link to that random character generator down in the description if you guys want to try this concept out on your own. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, leave a like. Subscribe to my YouTube channel if you're not already, and you can even ring the bell if you want to know exactly when the next video is coming out. Thank you to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. You guys can check out my website, 1000art.com, if you want to get a bunch of sweet merchandise with my art on it. I got t-shirts and hats and hoodies and long sleeves and all kinds of sweet stuff over there. Thank you so, so much to my patrons. Speaking of random characters, we got a bunch of random characters over there. Such a fun community over on Patreon. You guys support me on a monthly basis and make videos like these possible. I super duper duper appreciate you guys' support. You're the best people on the internet. Thank you. I had a lot more fun with this video than I thought I was. I almost like doing the random character generator more than the random creature generator. The random creature generator video had some really wild out there creatures that were just like absolutely insane. But this one was fun because it was a little bit more grounded and it gave me some room to be creative. Anyway, I had a good time. I hope you had a good time. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm 1000. I will catch you guys on the next one. Peace out. Hey, so before we go, the winner of the contest of the Angelus goodies that we were giving away on the last video is Brianna Marie. She said, I can't believe you got casted into the new Space Jam. That's insane. I never realized you were into acting. Congratulations, Brianna Marie. I'll try and hit you up and get your address so I can send you all this random stuff that Angelus gave me. And how dare you didn't realize I was into acting. I am a genius actor. Didn't you hear all the crazy voice acting I did in this video? Just kidding. Anyway, congratulations, Brianna Marie, you are the winner. And yeah, thanks for commenting. Thanks for playing along. Thanks for watching. All right, y'all. Peace out.